Yeah. Physicists used to believe that an atom is like a plum pudding.
What's a plum pudding?
It's like a raisin bun.
Oh, were the physicists very hungry or something?
Physicists knew that an atom contains both negative and positive charges. So they imagine an atom is like one big lump of positive charges with electrons sprinkled inside, like a soft, yummy bun with raisins. Then comes Rutherford's experiment. In the Rutherford's experiment, alpha particles were directed head-on into a thin gold foil. A detector is used to count the number of alpha particles at each angle of deflection theta. Physicists thought that since the mass and positive charges are distributed evenly in each gold atom, they should be spread so thin that the alpha particles should pass straight through with little deflection. In fact, Rutherford likened it to firing shells into tissue paper. There's no way the shells can bounce back. Guess what? The shells did bounce back. The actual results of the experiment showed that although most of the alpha particles passed through with little or close to no angular deflection, some were scattered through large angles. A few alpha particles, about 1 in 8,000, suffered deflections of more than 90 degrees, even reflecting backwards. Surely the plum pudding model is wrong. The positive charges and mass in the atom cannot be distributed evenly in the atom. Instead, they must be concentrated in a very small volume at the center of the atom. The rest of the atom is mainly empty space. This central charged region is now called the nucleus of the atom. The nucleus is so small that most alpha particles pass straight through the atom with little deflection. But the nucleus is so massive and concentrated that the alpha particles that do encounter the nucleus suffer large deflection. The experiment also showed that the size of the atom, which is of the order of 10 to the power of negative 10 meters, is incredibly large when compared to the size of the nucleus, which is of the order of 10 to the power of negative 15 meters. To put things in perspective, if the nucleus were the size of your head, the boundary of the atom would be a few kilometers away. Since we are all made of atoms, most of our volume is in fact empty space.
I get it. Physicists thought that an atom is a candy floss. But when they poked at it using alpha particles, they realized it is actually a lollipop.
Yes, but for the proportion to be correct, they would have been poking at a candy floss the size of a stadium.
Yummy!